Hello, greetings. This is Gilles Mancion. I thought I'd come and say hello, wish you a good day. I'm going to pull a few cards for we're moving towards the solstice. The solstice is going to be a very shifting time, hopefully. This morning, I woke up with the idea that I should shut up. So it's like, oh, today I'm not going to do a video. But then Spirit came back to me and said, well, it is kind of better to speak. And so I'm here. But I may do a break and not do videos every day from now on. For we are what we are seeking right now is going getting full circle to complete the program, whatever that means for us. Hein, for we are for sometimes we in this solstice we may be called to call into situation that we do not wish to get involved with. But if we are called to address them, then it's good to do it, to follow whatever guidance. Right now the Gemini is pushing us into all over the place. I know myself, I'm going from the heights of ecstasy to the depths of despair in one moment of time. It's not that very long, but it's like I feel like I'm tied up to a chair with a sort of Damocles that can kill me at any time. And I'm seeing before me a doorway that's with all kind of beautiful things, riches, love, abundance, success. And I'm like stuck to my chair here, and it's like, please God, free me up. And it's like, but it's like whatever, amor fati, whatever happens, happens. And so I surrender to that. And hopefully, but when tomorrow the sun is going to move into Cancer, so it will be we'll move into Cancer, so we'll be moving into the day with this summer solstice and the summer. The idea is to stay centered and heart connected. Working with try to connect as much as possible to this golden white light of the Christ. The Archangel Michael was saying that this summer and the end of the year will be about peace and joy. So let us hope that. I feel a great deal of tension. Sometimes I feel I have fulfilled my whole mission in life here. There is no more for me to do. I have done all I could, and if life doesn't deliver me, it's like I'm not adequate to live within in this survival mode. It's like but whatever happened will happen. For we are creating the illusion of being in physicality. We are creating the illusion of being mortal. We are creating the illusion of being disconnected. But this illusion appears very real through our emotional body. We have all those references that keeps us believing in those aspects. And so I hope I just wanted to come, and I'm going to pull a few cards to see what today what we may get from as guidance for the Dakini. For the situation is the magic carpet, is the ability to really, really shift to swiftly into something new. What comes around the situation is cutting through. Certain reforms needs to be done. What we see before us is the way through. It is the path of the hermit. It's about walking along if necessary, but about staying in the central line to seek and find as well. In the depths of our subconscious, the distant past, we have soma, the phallic mushroom. It is the illusion, the dream. The moon is the illusion. It is the dream. The emotional body is not the reality. It is just. It is a guiding post, but sometimes we are transmuting all kinds of energies from past life. That's why I'm trying not to accept my fate, because I do not know all those memories I need to transmute, and so I have to let go and accept and try to stay as positive as possible. What we see right now is death, so the possibility of natural transmutation. It can be physical death, but it can also be psychological death, to be reborn within ourselves. For the more we say yes to death, the more we'll be able to live. The less we're afraid of death, the more we won't be afraid to live as well. What's coming up in the near future is Mercury. It is the power of the one card, the magician. So we're going to be able to manifest. There's all kinds of new energies that I feel are coming. I want to be there already. What we have is our strength is the tree spirit, is the power of trees, is Shakti. Yakshi, it is called. It is the power of growth and evolution and be anchored within the earth as much as possible. What comes to us from the outside world is the phoenix, it is the sun, it is the rebirth, the renewal. What we have in our inner emotion is the ability to handle the hot seat, to be in charge, to be in responsibility. And the outcome is as above, so below. So there's like all kinds of blessings that will come down, that are coming down. It is just a matter of not allowing ourselves, which is not easy, mostly for me right now. I have only one desire. There's only one thing, is to find the finances to move out of this house and get put everything in storage somewhere. And so I can, then my mind will be free. Even if I have to wander in the street, to live in the street, that's no big deal for me. But I feel I have to save my paintings. Hopefully God will not place me in this position. And even if I would lose all my paintings, I still have photographs. So we'll see. Before whatever needs to happen will happen in any event. So I wanted to speak about cosmology today. For I'm not a divine counselor. I'm not like the spiritual expert on paradise and cosmology, but I have more knowledge than let's say a great majority of human beings in relationship to what is this primal sphere. For paradise is the primal origin and final destiny of all spirit personalities, and we are spirit personalities. So this painting behind me is a painting of cosmology, so the seven families of spirit beings, and it is symbolic of paradise, the seven satellites of paradise, the central universe, the two levels of dark gravity bodies, the seven super universes of time and space, and here we have two levels of outer universes. So essentially, the paradise and the central universe always have been. There's never been a time where the Son did not exist in relationship to the Father or the Spirit on paradise and in surrounded by the central universe, which is called Avona. And eventually, the mechanism of time and space have been activated to initiate the seven superclusters of galaxies that we know as the time and space reality. And we are part of the seven super universe. So essentially, paradise is the only place in the whole universe of universes that's fully stable, that does not move. Everything moves in relationship to paradise. Paradise is essentially flat. There is a personality lives on the upper surface and on the peripheral surface. It is 1/6 longer than the width, so it's a little bit longer than large, so it's more elliptical, and there is one tenth the peripheral is 1/10 the size of the width. The bottom of paradise is called Nizer Paradise, a great mystery. This three concentric zone of energies that are completely mysterious is where all space and all energy, they either come out or come in, but they never come in and out in the same times. For billions of years they come out, and then for billions of years they come in, and space is initiated below paradise, and time is initiated above paradise, for paradise does not exist neither in time or space. And so, right near paradise, there is three circuits of very exclusive world planets that are eternals. The first circuit is called the sphere of the universal father, the seventh sacred world of the father, starting with Divinington and finishing with Ascendington. Ascendington will become our residence place in between when we traverse the central universe before we achieve paradise status. But Divinington will never be invited to visit Divinington because it's the home of the prepersonal being, like as I am the I Am presence. But by the time we get there, we'll be fused with the I Am presence, but we'll be an ascending being. And so, outside of that, there is those spheres are all uniquely eternalized. They're huge spheres of reality. Then in the next level, there is another circuit that's called the shining orb of the eternal sun. Those spheres, as a personality, we will never also visit them because they're reserved to super personal beings. So even if we would go there, we would not see or feel anything because we're personal beings. And then there is the seven sacred worlds of the orbs of the infinite spirit, and it is the central focal point of the master spirit that governs all seven super universe from those spheres. And then there is 1 billion perfect world that compose the central universe with a perfect inhabitant, a huge planet. And so we are, as ascender, we'll have, once we achieve all the ascensions through the super universe, we'll have to traverse it, incarnate on all those billion perfect worlds, and then we'll eventually wake up in there as a paradise citizen. But we have to go into this deep sleep. It's the last sleep before we that will be the last sleep before we return to that paradise sphere where we become eternal beings. And then around that, there is two circuits of dark gravity bodies, and so everything in this that swings around paradise on the 21 satellites and the central universe, they all go clockwise, and they take 2 billion years to complete a cycle. When the first level of dark gravity body goes counterclockwise and the second goes clockwise, those dark gravity bodies are shared, creating a protection for nobody can ever penetrate the central universe that's not been qualified, and it makes the whole central universe completely invisible from a cosmic, any cosmic point. And so, and beyond that, there is the 7 super universe, for there are 7 super universe because there is 7 possible association of the trine deity. The first super universe is ruled as the universal father would rule it. It's probably the most advanced and most developed of all super universe. Then the second is ruled as the eternal son alone would administrate it. The third one is ruled as the infinite spirit alone would rule it. The fourth one is ruled as the father son would rule it together. The fourth one is like the father spirit will rule together. The sixth one is the spirit and the son. The son and the spirit will rule it together. And the seventh, the father son and spirit. So it is the less developed. We live in the 7th super universe. Its main philosophy is that we have to wait to ascend. And while we wait, we ascend. It's called Orvonton. It's the name of the master spirit number 7. And eventually, all of time and space, what we call the grand universe, will have achieved the maximum evolution on both material and physical, spiritual level, at which point everything, the whole master universe, the whole grand universe will be settled in light and life, and the first level of outer space will be inaugurated. The Supreme will come out of paradise as a full-fledged personality because he will be made of the sum total of all evolution. And so so the 7 super universe are going counterclockwise around the paradise center. The first level of outer space goes clockwise, and the second level of outer space goes counterclockwise. When we look through super telescopes, we can already see some of those super clusters that are beyond the 7 super universe. So it is, those are universes of the future. Also, that's not on the painting. There is paradise, and then it looks like, if we were to go from above, we would see that it gets bigger and bigger and bigger. It's like it gets larger and larger as we move outside of paradise. But above and below paradise, there is space reservoirs that are very mysterious. Nobody really knows what their future or even their function. What we know is that for 2 billion years they expand, and for 2 billion years they contract. When they contract, the space expands. When they expand, the space contracts. Right now, we are right at the phase where they're almost at the maximum point of contraction, and space is at the maximum point of expansion. And where we're going to move into this magical point, I don't know exactly when, because cosmic time, this is 2 billion year cycle as well. And so, those reservoirs will reach the bottom, they will be ready to expand again, all the space will begin to contract again, staying within each of their circuits, of course, because there is like everything is concentric circles. So it's like God bringing everything back to him in some sense. And so those reservoirs are quite mysterious. So if you would imagine the whole master universe, imagine that it would go infinitely, but that it would be like a Maltese cross, with the reservoir, and then all around there would be the physical pervaded space, and then there is unpervaded space between the reservoir. We have no clue of what will become of those unpervaded space. Maybe there's something for after the master universe. And so so I also wanted to discuss briefly I hope this, you find this interesting. It may be bizarre to speak about those things, but I thought I would anchor those energies today. For understanding, space only exists in relation to paradise and time as well. For paradise is made of a single matter. It's very, very, it's so small, it's so minuscule, they're little cubes, but anything can be done. Paradise is not a being, it responds to the will of deity and the will of those beings that live over there. And at the center of paradise, there is deity presence. This deity presence is at the center. There is the universal father, the first source of center, the one we want to fuse with, we want to become one wave, to return this one, return home. And so when we and his presence is surrounded by the eternal sun, for there is they always and the presence of the eternal sun is surrounded by the presence of the infinite spirit. Yet those beings, it has been revealed that on a sequential level, to understand, although it's like it's just a concept, because they've always been together. We could imagine a point before anything that the Father would at some point separate all that is personal within him and create an absolute Son, and then all that is non-personal within him that creates the infinite paradise, the absolute paradise. And the pressure tension between the personal and the non-personal eventuated the third being, the God of action, the conjoint actor that became fully conscious of the plans of the Father and the Son, and activated the mechanism of time and space before they activated the potential of paradise to create the central universe and the citizen of paradise, and then to activate the universe circuits as we know it, because we live in them, so we know they exist. And so around the presence of deity, which is at the center of paradise, because it's not because we attain paradise that we find God right away. We have to be prepared in this, we have to still be prepared. It's a long process, but it can already sink to the God of paradise. Always keep your focus on that. If you can think about that all day, you're going to save a lot of time to breathe in this light, to connect to your Father. And but God exists in many, many levels, and on all levels God is present in heaven as well. And so around that there is what is called the Most Holy Sphere. The Most Holy Sphere is a purely spiritual sphere. There is no material construction there. It is just a sphere that as for all kind of spiritual works, that's like and then around that there is seven concentric zone of residential. It's called the holy area, the holy areas. And those zones are so huge. Just to give an idea of what the first zone is occupied exclusively by the paradise citizen, so it is part of this huge, but it's so monumental, and everybody's got plenty of space there. For what I know, we have our own valley there. But then there is the next zone is the ascending space there. This is a circle around it that's divided in seven zones. Each zone is dedicated to the ascender of all the each super universe. So as we ascend, we'll have a residence on the seventh zone of the second circle. And to give an idea of the size, right now there is a one with 128 zeros of beings, 10^128. Resident. So it's like it's so huge and monumental, and that represents only 4% of the dedicated zone of that area. So it's like there is plenty of space for all kinds of inconceivable reality, the beings that will ascend eventually to the presence of God. And so I wanted to introduce some of those very more advanced. It's maybe 123, I took a note, maybe 128, 123, it doesn't really make much difference. But as time goes on, at the beginning there was nobody that could ascend. And one day there was the first ascender, came from the first super universe, his name is Ganfonda. Some greetings, he's the head of all finalitas, because there's the corpse of finality. For there is a great mystery also about the central universe, for those planets are magnificent beyond, I can't even conceive them, I forgot them, I don't know them. But I know that from some of the revelation that each of them is inhabited by an eternal of days and a universal census. Those beings that are absolute in their administrative skill and judgment of deity, but there is absolutely no need at this in our days and age for census to be stationed on those planets. So why are they here? It's kind of a mystery, and eventually there will be a change, because some of the Vornas are moving towards the super universe, and others are moving towards paradise to integrate the power corps of finality. So there is a shift in the population there as well. Well, I don't want to I don't want to make this too complex or too, but I just wanted to sort to speak about that, for it is something I'm really looking forward to reintegrate my home there. It is and to really to find my father, for I know my father's always there. It's just a matter, but we seem separated by consciousness, and that's all there is in. I'm gonna pull one more card. I'm not sure if I pull one of those. It's the queen of the lady of Michael, brilliant, autonomous, perspicace, having a sense of humor. You know exactly what to do. Put your experience in profit. Focalize more on your career than on a love story. So it's about taking care of the logistics, dropping the mask, changing the role, taking things lightly. And I hope you find this interesting, although that might have been a bit complicated to speak about that. Just wanted to remind you of your home, where you started from, where you came from, where you need to return to the source. And so ask always your guides and angels to assist you. And all this reality exists within us. It exists out there at the center of the universe, but it's also part of us. It is part of deep in our heart. We have that center, that paradise center, for paradise is the center of all things. So within all things, there is this paradise presence. I'm going to finish with a song. It's a random song. It's a French song. I just pulled out. It goes like this. Mon cœur se trouve au bout du monde, et moi je vis au jour le jour, comptant les heures et les secondes, me séparant de ton amour. Quand on se reverra, ma vie renaîtra, et je sécherai mes pleurs. Près de toi, mon ange, près de toi, en trouvant l'oubli des jours désunis, résonnera dans nos cœurs la marche des anges. Pour voir la fin de mes souffrances, je prie le ciel de me guider vers le pays de notre enfance, où tu te meurs à m'espérer. Quand on se reverra, ma vie renaîtra, et je sécherai mes pleurs. Près de toi, mon ange, près de toi, en trouvant l'oubli des jours désunis, résonnera dans nos cœurs la marche des anges. Dans le chaos de ma tourmente, je ne résiste que par toi. C'est ton visage qui me hante, et le son de ta voix. Vienne le jour de ma victoire, écrasant les années passées, où l'amour a vécu sans gloire. Viens avec toi le temps d'aimer. Quand on se reverra, ma vie renaîtra, et je sécherai mes pleurs. Près de toi, mon ange, près de toi, en trouvant l'oubli des jours désunis, résonnera dans nos cœurs la marche des anges. Thank you very much for sticking till the end. So I wish you a wonderful, wonderful solstice. I'm not really sure if I'll be returning soon or not. It's so much that is going on, from incredibly possible good to incredibly possible bad. So I'm just choosing the incredibly possible good and trying to breathe out everything else. But I just wanted to make a video today. I wish you a wonderful day. Thank you very much for liking, sharing, subscribing, commenting. And I'll talk to you later. Namaste.